everybody. Okay, January favorites. Yeah, January favorites time. So, first thing is The Making Faces by Kevin Acqua. Palettes, this is volume one. And let me just show you the stuff that's in it, and then I'll let you know what my favorites are. Okay, so this is what the palette looks like. You get three eyeshadows in the top. You get two cheek products right here, and then you get three lip colors down here. And then you get a little brush, which I've never used, and then a little applicator. My favorite out of this whole palette would have to be the first and the very last eyeshadow, which I don't know if you guys can see what they look like. I think you may still be able to get this from like Amazon. Next favorite is actually a face brush, and this is the e.l.f. small tapered brush. It's basically just as it's called, it's tapered and it's small. I really like using this for contouring. That's all I've really been using it for, contouring down the sides of my nose, the hollows of my cheeks, temples, up my hairline, and my jawline. Yeah, I've just been using this brush and I absolutely love it. I think you can get this for either $3 or $5 from eyeslipsface.com. It's from their studio line. So that is the small tapered brush. It's super soft, super inexpensive, applies powders, especially contouring powders, like crazy. I love it. Love, 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 love. So I've been using this over my Real Techniques contour brush. So, love it. And it's slightly cheaper than the Real Techniques brushes. I've also, I just found this again in my collection. This is the Revlon Colorstay Liquid Eye Pen. And it's in black, and it's just another felt tip eyeliner in black. I really, really like it. I stopped using it because I couldn't find it for the longest time, and then I guess it was kind of just hiding from me within my stash of a bunch of stuff. I really, really like it. It's long wearing. I find that it stays on my lids for over 8 hours without creasing. I do see that it kind of sort of creases a little tiny bit like on the 10th hour, and then by then I just take it off anyway, so it doesn't really bother me. It's not like a deal breaker or anything. So and I have oily lids, just, you know, so you guys can kind of see if maybe you want to try this or maybe not. But it did transfer after a really long period of time, and I just really don't recommend anybody keep their makeup on for that long extent of time anyways. So I've been really, really liking this. I'm pretty sure that Revlon still makes this. I've seen it at my Target a couple times. But yeah, it's the Revlon Colorstay Liquid Eye Pen. So I've been really liking this, especially for my lazy days where I just don't want to use gel liner or like a liquid liner. This is so much quicker because you kind of just pop it off. You don't have to shake it. You don't have to do anything or kind of wipe away any product. It's just the perfect amount of product on the tip, and it just applies a wing liner perfectly every time. The tip never gets dull. I've used this so many times, I think it's kind of almost drying out, but yeah. So anyways, I found this again in my collection. This is the MAC Luster Glass in Instant Gold, and this is like a classic that I think everyone should have. If you've never tried a luster glass and you're not really interested in luster glasses for whatever reason, just try Luster Glass for the fact that you need to try Instant Gold. Like, it is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful gloss from MAC. I hate MAC lip glosses. I really do. I don't think I can stress that enough how much I despise the MAC lip glosses. Their plush glosses I can tolerate, and their luster glosses I can tolerate. I can especially tolerate them as if when I find like a nice, like, a shade that stands out. I mean, this isn't like too big of like a standout shade. I mean, it's like a gold toned with, looks like little sparkles in it. There's like multi colored shimmers in there. Like, it's not chunky glitter like their dazzle glasses. It's just fine, fine shimmers. It looks like a really, like, finely milled shimmer. But it's so, so beautiful. I have it on right now over top my NYX lip liner in Nude Pink, which I lined my lips with, and then I filled in my lips because I always do that. This is like half the time when you guys ask, like, what is that color that's on your lips? Majority of the time, it's gonna be NYX Nude Pink lip liner. It's a lip liner, not a, like, it's not a lipstick or anything. I wish they'd make it in lipstick form, but it's just a lip liner. I am wearing this right now, and I'm wearing it over top the NYX Nude Pink lip liner, and this is the lip color that it comes out. So I like the lip liner on its own, and I also like it with this gloss. And then this is my new favorite. This is the Fergie Wet n Wild lipstick in Fergie Daily. I showed you this in my most recent drugstore haul. It's from the Fergie line or collection or whatever from Wet n Wild. And it's just a nude. A lot of people were asking, is this similar to the nude lipstick 902C or something like that from Wet n Wild? It's not. The reason why I love this is it is literally almost an exact dupe for Max Blankety. And this is Max Blankety. You can see, probably hold them side by side. Like, this one looks pinkier than Blankety, like just side by side, but swatched, they look pretty much the same. I'm just applying this with my finger. This one over here is Blankety. It has a slight pink tone to it, like pinkier, but you can hardly tell. Blankety, Fergie Daily. Now, the reason why I love Fergie Daily so much is it's a less expensive dupe. It's a dupe for me, for Blankety, in color. But Fergie Daily is pretty much like a satin finish, which is my favorite lipstick. Which is like my favorite lipstick finish of all time. So Blankety is an amplified lipstick, which I'm okay with amplifieds, I like them too, but I prefer satins. So I guess technically I would prefer the Fergie Daily color over Blankety, which I never thought I'd ever hear myself say about Blankety, but there it is. So if you haven't gone to your local drugstores that sell Wet n Wild to check out the Fergie lipsticks that she came out with, definitely go and find that Fergie Daily color because it's amazing. Especially if you've wanted to try Max Blankety and just really don't want to shell out the money for MAC. You're really just paying for the name anyways. I personally really, really love the Wet n Wild one, Fergie Daily, over MAC Blankety. Last but not least, this is kind of like two products, but I'm going to consider it one product because I can... Well, it's only a favorite when I use them together, and they're not like favorites separately. So I'm gonna consider them one. They're the two color whispers that I recently purchased in my recent drugstore haul. I know it wasn't like in the beginning of January, I kind of purchased them towards the end of January, but I'm still throwing them in my January favorites because I can. So anyways, I like these two. I have this one in Go Nude and this one in Orange Attitude. I like Orange Attitude over Go Nude, but I love it even more together. I don't really like the Go Nude one because it kind of looks weird and a little bit streaky on my lips. So I don't just wear it separate. Like, I never wear this alone, the Go Nude, but I will wear the Orange Attitude alone. Swatch them separately and then I'll let you know what I do. So I believe I already swatched these in that haul video. That's Go Nude, the one that you can't see. Okay, and then that's Orange Attitude, which I like. I like that color. I always put Go Nude on first and then top it with Orange Attitude. And I'm going to do that right here. So I already have Go Nude right there. I'm still swatching it as heavily as that one. Do you see how it's like slightly more toned down? And if I need to tone it down even more, I'll just go over it again with the Go Nude color. Oops, wrong swatch. So do you see how like it kind of turns it into a creamsicle color, which is what I love. I love orange lipsticks, orange glosses that kind of have that creamsicle look. However, I do just like it orange as is, but I just like these two together the most. I do really like the smell of these. The smell of these Color Whisperers are like Fruity Pebbles, the cereal. So that's probably why I reach for them so much. But I like both of them together, combination. I hope you guys found this video helpful or entertaining or both. So thank you all so much for watching and subscribing if you have, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!